It's already New Zealand's highest grossing locally produced film of all time, and it's hit box office records for the highest grossing opening weekend for all movies from anywhere in New Zealand. That's in New Zealand. Now, Hunt for the Wilderpeople has passed $3 million at the Australian box office, and it's picking up momentum over there. Hugely warm critical responses. Its US releases in a fortnight. Earlier today, I spoke with Sam Neill, who stars in the film as Uncle Heck, and asked him what it is about the film that has Australians flocking to see something that is very, very Kiwi.
I think it's a lot of things, but mostly because it's got heart and it seems authentic, and it's people are very touched by it and they find it very funny. And of course, they miss some of the New Zealand illusions, which we get, but it doesn't seem to matter. It seems to play internationally just as well as it does at home.
That's an exciting thing, isn't it? Because as New Zealanders, and you know this, and everyone listening will know this, we've watched EastEnders and we've watched Ken Loach films and Mike Leigh films and American movies with Southern twangs in, and we've assimilated that culture into our own, but we've been much less forthcoming about the right for us to take our culture to the world. And that's something that Tyke has been doing, that the Concords have been doing, and this is absolutely what this film does.
And the fight of the Concords, I mean, who would have imagined that Americans would get their jokes? Mm. They seem so specifically New Zealand, but, there's a lesson in this. If you try and do films that you think a Hollywood audience will enjoy, it never works.
Well, Hollywood's already doing that, isn't it, Sam? I mean, our point of difference is us, isn't it?
That's right. That's completely right. But I think what elevates the whole film is the authenticity of the reporters in the film, not just yourself. And by the way, I have been told reliably that there's a fair New Zealand contingent that in Australia, whenever you come on the screen, there's a round of applause.
They're just delighted I've got work, Sam, I think. what was it like to make? I mean, had you met Julian Dennison previously?
No, I didn't know Julian. I walked into we met at a costume fitting, and I was a little apprehensive because I knew I'd be spending 6 weeks with a kid,
and yes.
if he didn't get on, it'd be pretty trying 6 weeks. But I liked Julian immediately. He's a great kid. I love him to death, and he's very funny. So I loved having that time with him, and we're still friends.
Isn't that funny? Because I sense that's the appropriate word. You are friends. And isn't he a remarkable young guy? Because he ought to be now off the rails. I mean, he ought to be going Bieber, really. Should he be throwing eggs at the neighbour's house and behaving badly? He should be. But there's none of that going on. He remains still grounded and wonderfully himself.
I think that's, he's a smart kid and comes from a very good, large family who keep him grounded. And, he's completely unoppressed by anything that attaches to celebrity. So, he's from Myanmar. Of course he's sensible.
Have you watched it with an Australian audience? I know you've been doing the rounds and the marketing has been impressive and clever and engaging and all that stuff. But have you actually gone and sat in a cinema with an Australian audience and watched Wilderpeople over there?
I haven't sat through the whole thing, but I've come in at the beginning and at the end. Julian and I and Tyka did a little mini tour, and we'd come in and introduce the film and then come and do a Q&A at the end. And it is, I have to say, it's one of the most wonderful things when you walk into a cinema to spontaneous applause. But actually, the other odd thing is I get calls from friends that say, I went to the Dendy at a 3 o'clock session yesterday, and at the end, the audience burst into spontaneous applause. People clap at the end of this film. That never happens, does it?
No. The session I went to, people clapped. In part, it's because I mean, the simple truth of Julian's character is that he has been abandoned, that he's fallen through the cracks of the system, that he is alone in the world, that there is really no one to turn to. And that is a very contemporaneous story. That is a very timely story in New Zealand. And it's actually a sad and dark story, but it's redeemed because there is love and there is possibility and there is, and it doesn't seem corny, it does seem right, a happy ending. Is that what people love about it?
I think that's true, but, you know, because it is about serious things, and there is grief and abandonment and a sad undercurrent that goes all the way through the film. And if you read it on paper, you might think, oh, it sounds a bit sicky and, you know, sickly and sentimental to me, but in fact, it's quite dry and avoids all sentimentality, and people sort of appreciate that. Also, I think probably people are a little bit possibly tired with enormous CGI films where cities get destroyed and super people with superpowers fly around. I don't know. It's kind of not just contemporary, but it sort of harks back to films when they had a little more heart, when they had a little more compassion and human interest. I don't know. I'm only speculating, John. It's just the sort of feedback I'm getting, but it is, I've never really had feedback from anything I've done before like this.
Wow. In your long and venerable career, Sam, that's pretty wonderful.
Venerable.
It's venerable. Take it on the chin, man.
Vintage actor, Sam. It was veteran, and now I'm vintage.
Have you got your walking frame there, Sam? You're all right. Speaking of all right, you've just pulled out of something. Pierce Brosnan's going to replace you. What's going on there?
Oh, look, nothing dramatic. There's my doctor. That's a minor surgery. It's been overdue for quite a while. And then he said, look, we can't postpone this anymore. You just got to get it done. It's nothing dramatic. And so it was ill-timed. And so I've had to withdraw from the Sun. It's a really good job. And my friend Pierce Brosnan's taking over. And he'll be much better.
Well, he won't be as good looking as you. He won't be as good looking, Sam.
No, I have advised them, the wonderful producers are. I said, look, the only thing about Pierce is his ridiculous Irish good looks. I would encourage you to have the makeup department give him a good dose of 19th century syphilis. pustules and craters could do a tremendous amount for the whole look of the show. But I don't think they're going to take me up on that. But Pierce is a wonderful actor. He's a very old and close friend of mine, so I'm happy to see him in it.
Well, you look after yourself, Sam Neill, and congratulations on the extraordinary success of Wilderpeople. And it's lovely to talk to you as always.
It's very nice to have talked to a co-star.